Thank you. Shraddhe Joshi Sahab, Tandon Sahab, Lohia Sahab, all dignitaries on the dais, of the dais. There is a famous shloka in Upanishad which says that Om Purnamada Purnamidam Purnat Purnamudishyate Purnasya Purnamadaya Purnam Eva Asishyate. And literal meaning of this shloka is that you take whole out of the whole and still the whole remains. People at higher level of consciousness can understand it better, but people who are in materialistic business like me, who in the deals in commodity, we look at this shloka also in the context of data. And if you look at 1980 iron ore resources, it was more than 17 billion ton. We mined out 2,760 million ton from 1980 to 2010, and still the resources were more than 28. So that shows that the work which were done by the geoscientists at that point of time, and the story is not new. There was two known person, noted biologist Paul Ehrlich and noted economist Julian Simon. They had a bet in 1980 that five commodities, chrome, tungsten, nickel, chromite, these will be very costly in 1990. And the apprehension was that the population will increase, resources are finite, and the cost will go up. But it didn't happen. Paul Ehrlich, the biologist, lost the bet. But these were the things which were in 1980s. But if you look at the data of recent past, 2005 to 2015, we have seen 23% reduction in reserves of iron ore, 32% manganese reduction, bauxite it is 27%, copper it is higher to 44%, and lead and zinc reserves also has gone down by 16%. At the same time, if you look at the population, in 2005 it was 114 crores, and 2015 131 crores. So while the reserves have gone down by more than 22%, population has gone up by 14%. And that shows that tomorrow, if we have the reserve, a very good deposit below the earth, but the R&R cost will be so high that we will not be able to mine. It will be economically unviable for us, especially like country like India. For us, the exploration has to be done faster, and exploitation has to also be done faster. And for that, you need money. So we have 3,300 crores NMET fund. The spend is close to 415. But if you compare with the Australian data in 2020 calendar in Australia, the spend was more than $2,700 million. So that is the difference what we have. And we need to spend more on exploration. And government has taken a lot of initiatives on private sector participation, but I think it can be done more. And Australian reports also suggest that $1 investment in exploration gives you $11.4 revenue. And for us in India, where you have high bid premium mines, where miners are bidding at a very high bid premium, the revenue return will be more and more. The last point which I'd like to iterate here, which have been spoken by earlier speakers also, that while Government of India has taken a target of 2070 net zero, the exploration thrust can shift from the four major minerals which we are having in India to the minerals which are for the future, for decarbonization or for the net zero. And there lies the minerals which are needed for energy, rare earth, energy needed for distribution of those electricity, maybe aluminium, copper, steel, and minerals which are needed for the storage of those energy, cobalt, nickel, and other minerals. So, jana kaha hai to pata hai, kaise jana hai, ye bhi pata hai. Paisa chahiye, wo bhi pata hai. We need to put all the stakeholders together to reach the objective. Thank you very much.